It's a new week and a new project working on the ox cart block, but today I'm not working on the ox cart block. I'm actually working on Salt River Valley Yard down here, and I'll show you what. Let me swing you around here again. Swap hands, whole swap hand things. What I'm actually working on is the dreaded filler pieces here in the yard body for Salt River Valley Yard. I'm going to insert all these ties so I can paint it. Once this is painted, I'll continue on an ox cart block, but I want to get this painted while I have all the drop cloth available and take care of that issue. So I'm going to get started on that. It's probably going to be a fairly exciting, non-exciting video because I hate doing this. I think a lot of people do. That's why you see all these gaps everywhere. Some of those solutions are filing down ties out of flex track. There's Pico, I can't think who it is at the moment, makes little insert ties for N-scale. I'm pretty sure they're done for HO2. Those are a pain to install. So if we walk around over here on my printer, I'll show you what I did do. I made my own inserts. And when we come to install them, I'll show you what I've done. They're actually kind of easy to install because I'm lazy. They don't require any glue. They actually snap in place. So you just slide the part in, push the wedge in, it snaps the ties in place to the rail. No glue required. Easy. The only problems I'm going to have is I have to come up with probably a gluing solution. And so let me put the camera up here so you're not in the dead zone. For the spots where the insulated joiners are, so I'll make little special inserts for this on the printer. And I will get started. I'll probably show you what they look like. I'll pull out another camera so you're not getting the fisheye lens like normal, and we'll start installing these little inserts, and I'll show you how they were designed to work and how I do it. It goes really quick. So it's a lot quicker than gluing and tweezers and all that other stuff where you did the individual ties. So let me put my pointer down. I will be back with you with another camera. Now I want to show you what I made for my tie inserts. I'm going to put this here because it's white. So I made them in 2 and 3 tie groups. So you have the basic tie, which is the top part that actually tucks under the rail. Then below that, you have what I call the wedge. I don't know if you can see the wedge. It's a little edge on here that slides underneath the tie and pushes it up against the bottom of the rail. And they have a little guide strip. That's why they're a little bit wide, so they guide underneath the tie. So there's a wedge, a tie group, and another wedge. Real easy to install with simple tools. It doesn't take long to install them at all. So if I'm working on a section, I'll take a tie group, and this one here is a wider section, so it might fit a 3. Actually, I think I'll do better with a 2. So this will take a double. I could probably put a 3 into it if I wanted to. It's a little tight for a 3, so we'll use a 2. And it's very quick to install. Let me grab some tools. So what I normally do is I'll take a section of business card, or this case, a waybill, slide it underneath. I'll slide the tie group underneath the rail. And there's a groove in top that actually fits around the joiners. Then I'll take and find the wedge side of the wedge, slide it underneath,
I'm doing this all with the camera with poor lighting at the moment. And you just push it in, and when you push it in, you pull this out. I'm trying to be out of the way here. And I'm filling it all up. Let me do that again. Let's try that one more time, because I'm not looking. I'm looking at the camera, and I should be looking at what I'm doing. So you just line it up, pull that out, it gets it under the wedge, and you just push it in. Give it a little see. And that's it. This is now complete. Look at that. That was that simple. Sometimes you might want to square up the edges a little bit of the ties, just square them up. But no glue, no fuss. It's pretty quick. I'll do another one. I think I can see on that one on the camera. Is that a three? Yeah, that one takes three. So we'll do a three group. And the top, I don't know if you can see this or not, but the top is got a small profile. It's 3D printed, so it's not perfect. It's not going to fool anybody in like super close-up photos. But it does the job. It's got a little groove. Like I said, it's got grooves that wrap around the joiner. So if you're doing it in a blank rail, it'll have a bigger gap, but these are just designed to go around where the rail joiners are. Put my little piece of card down here so I can slide it underneath. You can do this without this little piece of card here. It just makes it easier, I found out after doing a couple of these. Make sure you find that side with that wedge on it. And so there's a wedge, makes it easier to slide it underneath. If you slide the blunt side in, it's just pushing around. So you want to use the wedge side. Put it down there. Get your tool, whatever you're using. Line it up. Give it a little push so the wedges lift underneath. Pull it out. Push it in. And there we go. It's done that quickly. In fact, they do better than I actually thought they would do, because after I put these in, I lose them where I've actually installed them. So I think they're doing a pretty good job. I can square up the ties a little bit, just square it up. Make sure everything's pushed down inside the tie, and you can move them back and forth like that, so it doesn't hurt them. As you set them in place, it cleans them up a little bit. Make sure your insulated joiners are still where they're supposed to be. Great tool. Order this on eBay. It's a wedge. It's a microchip lifter. It's in my eBay. Or not in my eBay. In my Amazon link. So check those out. And you just take that, and I'm blocking the camera so you can't see what I'm doing. And just slide that into place. Like that. And there you go. That's as easy as it is. I'm going to film in closer so you can watch a close-up on how I do this. And then I will let you go, and I'll just start catching up and doing a whole bunch of them. I'll do this one here. Let me close up on you. We'll start with the tie group, and I think this is going to be a three. Three's a little bit, might be too wide. Check out a two. It's an either or. It could be two or three for this tie group. I think I'm going to go with a three. If it doesn't work, I just pull it out and put in a two. Slide the card underneath. And the main purpose of the card is just to make it easy to lift the tie group up to get the wedge underneath. Look at my wedge. And you'll see the wedge right there. It's got a little wedge on it. And it's got the guides that lock it into place and lock the ties in place. So I got my wedge. I hope you can see that. So looking at the wedge, as I'm holding in the wrong spot, you'll see that the wedge is on one end flat, the other. It's got the guides that actually lock it in place in between the ties so it doesn't slide out. So that's how that works. Lift up the paper, push the wedge underneath, guide it in place. Because I'm doing this on camera and talking, it seems like it's a little bit harder than it really is. And that's it. It is done that fast. Line it up, make sure it fits, make sure the joiners are set. And granted, I have loose joiners for expansion purposes. I do have solder joints on either side, so that's cool. And that's it. That's a 3 tie group. Maybe we'll do a 2 or something. I'll focus in on another one. We'll do one more. Hang on. As promised, this should be a double. It looks just right for a double. Take and slide the card underneath. And it just makes it easier for putting the wedge underneath. Really need to do this. I just found out it makes it a lot easier to do it this way after doing a bunch of them. It's just hard to get the wedge underneath that without a little bit of guidance. And there's the wedge for the double wedge. You can see that the wedge is here, squared. The guides that actually, like I said, the guides will lock it into place once it's underneath. And you just push it down underneath the paper. Oops, I pushed it out. See, that's kind of why you want to use the paper, because sometimes you, when you're pushing the wedge underneath, it pulls it out. Just pull the wedge out once it's in, line it up, and there you go. And the interesting thing about the wedge is once it pushes the tie piece up against the joiner, you can actually pop out the wedge and it holds it in place. Or the joiner, I should say, will hold the tie piece in place. So if I wouldn't take the wedge out. It just keeps everything in place when you ballast it. But it works. In fact, it's nice and smooth. I knocked that up and push that down. And again, loose joiners because I have insulator or drop feeders on each side. You can't see those off camera, but they're there. There's one here and one here. So I'm going to continue on with this, and I'll be back with you when this is done.
The time to do this project went really quick. It wasn't even an hour. Just using those inserts, those tie inserts that I made, I finished up the main yard body of Salt River Valley Yard. Granted, when it gets painted, it should go away, but you can tell, if you look hard enough, you can see where I placed them. And I think it's more due to the fact of the rail joiners than anything else. Like, I know there's one right here, and there's a couple of them. Oops, I missed a couple. I had the box sitting on that when I started, so I need to put 2 more in here. But I'm going to come in and complete the task. I've got points down here that need some. Then I'm going to fill in all the singles. So as we know with Atlas track, you've got the snap track, which has a filler tie. I can't put a double in there, so I'm going to have to fill those with singles. That'll be tomorrow's project. I'll talk to you about that probably tomorrow. And where the insulator rail joiners are, I can't fit those tie inserts under those, so I'll make a custom one that will actually fit in between the insulated rail joiners. But again, that's for tomorrow's project. But for now, Salt River Valley Yard is actually coming on rather nicely. Once I get this filled in and painted, I will, I'm not gonna ballast it, but I'm gonna get it painted, do a little bit of airbrushing on it with individual tie colors, you know, give it a little worn out look. Get that taken care of. I can get back up to the oxcart branch. Oxcart block. You need to quit saying branch. I can get back up here on oxcart block and continue on. I just want to get all the spray painting done in this room while at the time when I have the drapes up or the drop cloth hanging. The only thing that I'm not getting done is take you around the corner. I still haven't decided what I'm going to do over here. I really don't want to spray paint anything. So I'll have to figure out what I'm going to do to fix this. If you notice, it's been rolled. I repainted this wall. It was, if you look further down, you can see that it was all had a background behind it. But when we did the addition to the house, they had to do work here on the wall. So I ended up having to repaint it. In fact, you can see where they put in the new, or the old wall used to be in the new drywall, because I went in old ceiling color, new ceiling color. You can see that I need to paint the ceiling color. I still have some old stuff all the way out to the edge so it blends right. And then I painted in where they replaced this drywall here when they took out the door here. But that's a project for another day. Oh, if we turn around, I have a whole set of inserts laying on the printer. So I'm ready for tomorrow in other areas. But for now, put away the old stick, and I will say, see you later, and stay frosty, my friend.